So, here is my new bike. Honda CBR 1000RR Fireblade. And it's just absolutely beautiful. Love the front. The way the front face, those headlights, fantastic. Okay, it's not as beautiful as an Italian Ducati or something like that, one of those exotics. But it's still a looker, and I have to say, I think the tricolour is the best colour in the blade. I really don't like the Repsol colours. It's that orange, I just can't get used to it. But it's just beautiful. I mean, you know, look at the quality of the welding on the swing arm there. Really nice. And there. Cockpit's really nice. It's got the show a big piston forks, front forks, and at the back it's got the show free balance rear shock. Up front, Tokiko calipers, and at the rear it's got Nissin calipers. This has got the electronic combined ABS. Done 40 or 50 miles on this now, and it's really, really good. Really good. Yeah, plenty of stopping power. So, the blade. And I've wanted one of these ever since I first saw one of these. 1992 when that first came out, and geez, yeah, I loved it from the very first day, and it's taken me 24 years to realize that dream. 24 years, but here it is in the flesh. It's superb. Absolutely love it. Yeah, there have been more exotic, nicer bikes. Yeah, the Honda RC30 and RC45, fantastic. The 9160 Catti, I mean, loads. But this to me is the, yeah, achievable superbike, the affordable superbike. And do you know what? I've had the bug. I've had the bug for a Lita bike ever since I got on the Panigales at Silverstone. And I'm keeping my 650. That I'm going to use every day for workhorse work. Yeah, commuting to and from work, all that sort of stuff. But this is going to be my fun weekend bike. And boy, is it a lot of fun already, I can tell you that. So yeah, no, I had the bug for this ever since I rode those Panigales. And then last week I had the couple of hours with the Fireblade SP, which you might have seen the video for. And then when I got back to the dealership, they had this baby sitting in here. I mean, it's registered 2016, but it's actually a 2015 model Fireblade. And they've had it sitting in the showroom for a little bit, and I presume that they wanted to get shift it and make some space, because they were offering the most unbelievable deal. I have taken it on a PCP plan over 3 years, but Honda UK put money down to as deposit contribution. My dealer put money down as a deposit contribution, and so effectively, yeah, this bike is what, 12 and a half, 12 and three quarters brand new. And if you crunch all the figures, I've effectively got this for just under 10 grand. So 2.5, 2 and 3 quarters, nearly £3,000 saving off list. And I just couldn't turn that down. So yeah, I put down, I don't know, 200 or 300 quid deposit. And it's costing me £119 a month. I think it's the deal of the century to have this. So that's why, well, I wanted one for ages. I wanted the fun, but you know, it's all very well wanting something and then actually it being achievable and being affordable. And very fortunately, because this is last year's model and they wanted to shift it, it was affordable. So I'm a lucky, lucky boy. And I suppose also this is great to pick this up because, okay, you could argue that it's got the electronic brake-by-wire ABS system on it, which isn't entirely pure sports. But you know what? I like that safety on the road. But this is probably the last chance to own a kind of unadulterated Fireblade, because next year they're going to bring out one with all the electronic toys on it to compete with the other bikes. So yeah, this is probably the last chance to have one without anti-wheelie, traction control, yeah, lean sensors, or all that jazz that, yeah, the other big liter superbikes have. So this is probably the last pure Fireblade before it gets all modern and technical. So yeah, was it 170-ish, 180, between 170 and 180 horsepower under my right wrist. And yeah, the only form of traction control is my brain telling my wrist to just be careful. And it has got tons and tons of power. And what I really like about this bike is it's not all just up at the top end. Yeah, it does, it's got it, but it's got great mid-range as well. It's just really road user friendly for a litre bike. So yeah, here it is. Here's my new bike reveal. My new Fireblade. So hopefully I'll do some get some miles on this and some adventures and some fun with it. I'm going to post up some videos in due course. But yeah, I'm going to go off now and put some miles on and enjoy it.